And so this is how. This is how you get to the documentation necessary to support a minor impact soft tissue spinal injury claim for policy limits up to $110,000. This is exactly what I did to win my case. I took a patient who was receiving no offer from the insurance company. She had an emergency room doctor saying there was nothing wrong with her because she didn't have a broken bone. Then eventually she went to the medical doctor because she was still in pain. Medical doctor x-rayed her and there was no broken bone. So he gave her the typical sprain strain, gave her analgesics, muscle relaxers, and pain pills for all three phases of healing. And we know that in the second phase, the repair phase, those now inhibit collagen synthesis and the healing process. So the insurance company had two medical doctors saying the patient was totally okay. And by the way, the patient didn't have any broken bones, no disc injury, no nerve injury, no mild concussion. All she had was a soft tissue injury. She had altered intersegmental motion. That's what she had. And I took that case. And she, by the way, she had normal range of motion. Medical doctors test gross range active motion. They don't test overpressure. They don't test joint motion. And so I took that case and documented it. And I showed how she had altered, the injury was altered intersegmental motion. And her positive findings were only range of motion positive in extension or flexion and overpressure, positive Kemp's test, and she had altered intersegmental motion with the intersegmental and that joint motion analysis, and she had a positive McNabb's line. It's when the inferior facet encroaches upon the superior facet. And I took that case with two medical doctors, and I used this exact formula that I just showed you. I used the exact documentation that we teach. I used the exact medical sales to sell the attorney. So this attorney had nothing, and he was not using chiropractors, and he didn't know what chiropractors could or couldn't do. And so I sold that attorney. That's called educational sales, because advertising would not have worked because he wasn't looking for a chiropractor. So my educational sales sold him. Then my documentation documented. And then I went in front of a jury. So we went to a jury because they were offering nothing. And so I explained how that patient had that injury from that accident, how she had altered intersegmental motion. I explained how that was an impairment rating based on the AMA guides. Then I showed the pain and suffering she had in the activities of daily living and the restrictions and pain she had, especially how she could not pick up her child and hug her six-year-old child. And then we explained the need for future care. And all of it was the documentation was a combination of totally subjective, how she felt, to totally objective x-rays that showed aberrant intersegmental motion, and everything in between, subjective and objective, orthopedic tests, range of motion tests, those are a hybrid of subjective and objective. So we used a combination of all of those to put the case together, and then I was able to show the jury and explain, based on the three phases of healing, why she had a permanent injury, why it was abnormal, and why it was a pathological process, and why she was going to need care the rest of her life. And that was based on what the treatment was based on, the three phases of healing and the biomarkers. And that case came back. It was a soft tissue, minor impact, soft tissue injury case. And I just shared with you the findings. No disc injury, no nerve injury, no mild concussion. And it came back to $110,000. It came back to policy limits. In this particular case, the policy limits were $110,000. It was the largest civil award ever in the county. And that's how, of course, after that, I never had to market again, because he totally believed in what I knew how to do, And of course, his circle of influence found out real quick. So I immediately had his immediate circle of attorneys and then some peripheral attorneys that knew about the case. So immediately, I became the authority in personal injury with that group of attorneys and received all the referrals. And a couple things also happened. I never had an attorney that I educated ask me to cut my bill. Never. Because of two factors. Because I didn't have an outrageous bill relative to the documentation I could support that could demand a threefold ratio on the claim. That's why. And the other reason is so it fit the document, the model of reimbursement. And the other reason, there's no doubt in my mind, is there was nobody they could have gone to. There's no other doctors in my county that they could have gone to. They did not want to get me pissed off. They did not want to not have me available. And that's what chiropractors don't understand. They suck up to attorneys. And the more you suck up to them, the weaker you become. And if you don't know the documentation and you don't have the ratios, then you're pissing them off. So either you're sucking up and being weak, or you don't have the documentation and you're pissing off referral sources. And neither of those are the solutions. The solution is understand and know how to document the minor impact soft tissue injury case and then know how to present it. And that's when you win, the patient wins, and the attorney wins, and you get inundated with attorney referrals. And they never will ask you to cut your bill.